Bless the name of Jesus. It is time for the super natural word for the day. Today, Wednesday, August 11, 2021, Pastor Dennis Amos Amajong, our spiritual father, has a beautiful message for us entitled, Prosperity is your heritage. Prosperity is your heritage. Our opening scripture is taken from the book of Psalms, chapter 35, verse 27. It reads, Let the Lord be magnified, which hath pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Pastor Dennis says, Every Christian has the right to be happy, prosperous, healthy, and sound. In the book of 3 John chapter 1 verse 2, the Apostle John reveals the mind of the Spirit, saying, Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. You don't have to pray or beg God to prosper you, because the Christian isn't that poor thing trying to be rich, but the rich discovering his inheritance in Christ. Pastor Dennis' father says, Financial prosperity is your God-ordained right, for you are the seed of Abraham. The Bible says, Abraham was blessed in all things. You can see that in the book of Genesis, chapter 24, verse 1. The Bible continues to say that Abraham was rich in cattle. He was rich in silver and in gold. Like Abraham, you have been blessed and enriched in all things and to all bountifulness. In the book of Galatians chapter 3 verse 29, it says, And if ye be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. You are an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ. Pastor Dennis continues to say, Being a joint heir with Christ means all his estates and assets are yours, as much as they are his. You own everything Christ owns. Paul understood this. Having studied the scriptures, he concluded, All things are yours. You can see that in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 21. You don't have to struggle for anything in life. You have been granted everything you need. This is your calling. The day you became a Christian, you embraced a heritage of blessings and endorsed the life of supernatural prosperity, success, and victories. Shout glory to God. Hallelujah. Today, we have two meditation scriptures. The first one is taken from the book of 2 Peter, chapter 1, verse 3. It reads, As his divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness, through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and virtue. Our second meditation scripture is taken from the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 3. It reads, Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. Our one-year Bible study plan. Today, we will be studying the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 21 and chapter 22. And we will also be studying the book of Acts, chapter 10, verse 1 to verse 23. Now it is time for our prophetic declaration. I request you to rise up on your feet, lift up your hands, so we can say these words together over our lives. Please repeat after me. Blessed Father, what a place I have in Christ, and what joy fills my soul to know that you have blessed me with all I require for life and godliness. Mine is a heritage of blessings and a life of supernatural increase. prosperity and glory in Christ Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, begin to speak in tongues as you affirm those words over your life. Mashata ya baba rebo shia baba. Mantayanda mako shata yanda mantaya baba rebo shia baba. I thank you, Father, for I am prosperous. It is my heritage. In Jesus' name, amen. Shalom.